Hey guys, welcome back to the very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and today we'll be working on this logo. The logo is very simple but has got some unique style. The design has got some identical shapes but in different sizes and color. The shape has been rotated for multiple number of times by setting the pivot at one corner. So to design this logo, we'll first use the rectangle tool and create a square. We'll modify that square into the shape, then after that with the help of rotate tool, we'll duplicate it and rotate it to an angle for multiple number of times by setting the pivot at one corner. Then after that, we'll modify each shapes and fill up the color and text. So let's begin the tutorial. First of all, I select the rectangle tool and with a shift and alt press, create a square. Then we'll fill this up with some plain color for a while. And let's modify it. So to go to transform and share. And under share, let's play with the angle here. So we got this square, so let's play around with the from this angle and this angle. So we have to maintain that here. And here I'm giving around 64 and here 68. And click OK. So we got a shape, similar shape like that. And now we have to modify. So first I'll create this shape. So I'm creating this list 1 2 3 4 5 6. So we got a 6, and after that, that 6 has been repeatedly duplicated. So I'll duplicate, create that. So first of all, I make this thin with a shift press, just making it thinner like that, and with a pivot center here, I'll just use the rotate tool and set a pivot around this corner and maybe okay that corner, that's good. And with the alt press, just duplicate it, and I'm keeping it around here, and I'll just scale this down a little bit around this much. This is the second one, and it has to be more smaller, and it has got some thickness, so let's increase it. And let's give the opacity for now around lesser so that we can see that intersection here. So I'll just do is I'll just modify a little bit. So setting the pivot that there, I'll just move it a little bit here so that we can do that. And after that, again we'll duplicate this with the alt press, just click and drag and duplicate it one more around this much. And this one will increase the size till around this much. Let's check it out. Okay, we can make it a little more thinner like that with the shift pressed. Then freeze it a little bit like that. Now duplicate it one more with the rotate tool selected, set a pivot at this corner with the alt press, just click and drag, and we'll create this here, and we'll make this smaller and thicker. So with the I'll just make this smaller here like that, and let's make it thick. So with the alt pressed, you can make it thicker in a simultaneous way like that. And we'll duplicate it one more with the rotate, set a pivot around here with the alt press, just click and drag and create this shape, this one, and that is long, so we have to make it longer like this much, maybe good. And we'll make it thinner like that much. Let's check it out. Okay, that's fine. We'll duplicate it one more time, last one, last piece. With the rotate tool selected, select that, set the corner, and with the alt press, just create the duplication. Then this should be the longest one. So with the shift press, just make it longer like that, and that's all. Now let's fill this up with the colors. So I select this with the eye picker. Here's the color. Selected that. Select this with the eye picker. Selected that color. Selecting this with the eye picker, with the alt and shift press, selecting that color. Selecting this with the eye picker, select that green color. This one, eye picker, selected that pink color. This one, selected that yellow color. Now let's arrange some stuff here. So first of all, what we need here is, let's see, this is, ungroup it first, let's, and now if we check it out, this is on the top. Okay, this one is on the top, then this, then it's on the back side. So this is on top. So let's arrange it to front like that. Now next thing, let's check it out.
this one, if you check it out, I think this one is behind to everything. So we have to do that. So selecting that, arrange it to back. So we got that. Now once we have done that, all that correction, we will give that details. So let's give that. So I'll duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and scale it down. Scale it down. I'll fill this up with white color and arrange it to front. And we'll go to here, transparency, and here right now it's color burn, so I'll keep that normal. All okay. Before we go that, let me show you this. If I select this, the color is blue, but we have given color burn option here. Under transparency, we have given this effect to everyone so that we can see that intersection part in some highlighted mode. So we need that. So we created that once. I'll duplicate it one more. We need one around here. So let's select this, Control C, Control F, arrange it to front and scale it down. And let's fill this up with the white color. And let's change the color to normal. And let's fill this up with the white color from there. And let's place it at the place. So let's place it around here and let's reduce the size a little bit and the depth like that and place it there. We'll need one more, so I'll just click and duplicate it there and set the angle here and place it there. So let's rotate the angle a little bit and set there, and let's reduce the size like that. Now let's see what else we need here. We have kept that. We need one around here. So I just select this, Control C, Control F, arrange it to front, change it to normal, fill it up with white color, and I'll just scale it down to this much and place it here. I'll just make sure to scale it down more like that. Now we need few more pieces here. So selecting that, duplicate it, scale it down and place it here. We'll fill the color from here like that, or maybe this like that. We'll duplicate it a few more stuff. I'll duplicate this, scale it down, and let's fill this up with the green color with the eye picker. Select that green color, or maybe yellow color from here. Now we need one more around here. Select that, scale it down and rotate it to a certain angle like that. And if you check it out, it's looking good. And let's fill this up with the pink color. So with the eye picker from that pink color like that. Now let's see what else we need. One around here, you can see this green color. So what I'll do is duplicate this and bring it around here, rotate it to a certain angle like that, scale it down a little bit and increase the little bit thickness here, and I'll just make sure it's a little bit smaller. And let's fill this up with the color. So I choose this green color and place it there and a little bit closer to that. Now once we have created all this stuff, I'll just select everything and Control G to group it. But before we go that, if we check it out, we got some certain space at this. So we need to set that up first. So what I'll do is ungroup that and I'll draw out a circle here. So I'll just draw out one circle from here and setting that pivot and just make sure this much big circle. And what I'll do is let's change the stroke color and reduce the stroke thickness like that, a little bit like that. Make it black so that we can see it as easily. Now what I'll do is I select each pieces and push it up, setting that endpoint to this circle. So just select it, push it up till this much, intersecting that. The same way, select each pieces, click, drag it up and place it there. In the same way, select this, drag it up, place it there. Select this, drag it up, place it there. Selecting that, drag it up, place it there. Last piece, drag it up, place it there. So if you check it out, we have placed it. Now I can just delete it out, and what I'll do is, now I'll group it up. Control G. Now, next thing is, with the rotate tool selected, I'll set the center point to this, and with the Alt press, just click and drag and rotate it. And duplicate it one. Control D. So let's check it out. It's looking good. Now what we'll do is, we'll select everything and I'll just rotate it to certain angles such that we got this shape. So here, if you check it out, we need this here like that. That's going there, and also we need this to be in the diagonal line. So let's make it linear like that. If I bring out a ruler, Control R, and place it around here, center. So let's place it at the center like that. And if I select all these pieces and rotate it and make sure that it passes through that center point like that. Now what I'll do is select everything and make a diagonal line from the center. So with the Alt press, select, click, and with the Alt press, just drag and create a straight line like that. And selecting everything with the shape builder tool selected, let's make this one object. So I fill this up with different color like blue and make it one object, removing everything like that. From here also, just making this one object, this one, selecting that, this white piece. So everything has to be removed from here like that. I just select this piece also so that it doesn't create any shoof, and like that, that. So we have selected everything. Now after that, select this and delete it out. So select everything from the downside. Before that, just ungroup this up, selecting that, ungroup it. Now select there, delete it. Select this, delete it out. Let's check it out. Okay, that's good. We can do some adjustments here. From here, we can just extend this a little bit so that we can balance it. So select that and just bring it till this much. So after setting this, I'll just delete all the extra pieces from outside like that, delete it out. And if you check it out, we have done it. Group this up, Control G, and place it there. And I'll just work on a text, T. Chemology, and I'll use the font text gray advendor. So I'll just select that and selecting that color, and I'll make it regular, and I'll just increase the font size a little bit like this much and place it around here, the logo below that. And after that, I'll just increase this into bold. So selecting that, making it bold, and under character, let's give some spacing to all the text. So go character, go there, and let's give the spacing. So let's give it around maybe, and let's reduce the font size a little bit, and this much. Okay, let's check it out. Okay, 670, that's good, and place it there. Finally, we have completed our logo. We can work on this logo for more details, like doing tweaking and stuff. So for now, it's fine. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more of this on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.